Hey, William here. In this training video, I'm going to show you how I vacuum gutters. So you can see in this gutter here, there's a fair amount of sludge, sand, and it's wet and nasty. Not a whole lot of tree debris in this time. So, what you want to do when you're vacuuming gutters is, first of all, get your water so that there's enough water in there and it flows nicely in the vacuum hose. There you go. That's step one, get it nice and wet, and you take your vacuum hose and put it back here. And you can see how it flows nicely in the hose that way. If this is really dry, or if it was sludgy and there wasn't enough water in there, it could cause the vacuum air to start to plug up. And that's what you really want to avoid when vacuuming gutters out. Even this, I'm going to have to run a bunch of water through this line because sand tends to really plug up this vacuum hose. If you don't have enough water flowing through, it will get clogged, and then it's a nightmare trying to unclog it. So, best to always use a lot of water when you're vacuuming. And that is when I typically vacuum, is when things are kind of sludgy and mucky. If it's bone dry, you could vacuum, but if it's kind of mucky and whatever, you're going to have to use water to rinse it first. Get a lot more water in there to vacuum it. Bone dry though, like you might just want to scoop it into a bucket and put that way to keep it dry. But when it's sludgy and you don't want to be getting all disgusting and filthy using the bucket method and the scoop method, then vacuuming is really ideal for that. You see what a great job vacuuming gutters does. I'm doing this. I don't use vacuuming on every single gutter. You know, if it's full of tons of debris and things that'll clog up the vacuum hose, I'll typically just scoop and bucket the whole thing and then maybe give it a final rinse of water. Yeah. There's a brief demonstration on how to vacuum gutters effectively. Come back for more training in future videos. Thanks.